I really wanted to point out something that's been happening in the community. Not recently, I would say in the last year or 2 years, I've been noticing that more and more service dogs are being rejected from restaurants, from stores, from markets. It's really strange. I don't know what's going on. But I just want to let you all know that you have rights, correct? You've read the ADA, right? And if someone starts to argue with you in terms of why you're not allowed in the store, you're not allowed in the restaurant, and they even threaten to call the police. Let's say the discussion gets to that point. Well, I'm going to call the police on you. Let them do it. You just stay as calm and as educated as possible. I know that, you know, you want to protect your service dog and you want to come in, you know, with your service dog as you're supposed to. And you don't want to continue to have this discussion because the ADA clearly states that you have permission to come in. You know, when you run into those obstacles, know that it probably is a lack of training for that person, or they're from another country and that didn't enter into their training and they have no idea that we have all these laws on the books to protect service dogs and their owners and where they can go. So if the discussion, you know, you don't want to make it escalate. You just want to be as calm as a cucumber. I know that some people are very sensitive. So, you know, when you start to stutter and it's like, what do I say next, you know, to this person? And you can always say, well, please go get your manager or your supervisor and let's finish off the conversation. So, and they might say, no, you need to leave right now. It's like, I'm not leaving, sorry. So you just have to remain as calm as possible so that the conversation remains calm. And if you're calm, then, you know, the other person hopefully will remain calm. But if, again, if they threaten to call the police, just let them do it because that's in your favor, actually. That's in your favor. Now, there is one person I want to put Paul as an example. I watch Paul, Matthew and Paul on YouTube, and Paul is blind. He doesn't use a wheelchair, but that's fine. I like to learn about other people with disabilities and how they solve their problems and how they work things out, you know, whether they have a wheelchair or not. They have a disability and they have their challenges. So I want to mention Paul here because he went to a restaurant to meet up with a friend. And I'll put a link to his video down below so you can look at his video. It's very interesting. He has a service dog and Paul is blind. So he was going into the restaurant and the waiter, you know, stopped him and said, no, you can't come in. And then said a couple of other rude things. And then it escalated to, you know, I'm going to call the police. And of course, that's kind of like a bombardment of information to you. And all of a sudden it's like, oh my gosh, you know. So Paul got a little frazzled and he left. And his reaction, of course, was to post something about the incident and mention the restaurant, and things kind of got a little bumpy there. But it has a very good outcome in which the manager, I guess, heard about the situation and felt really bad for Paul, called him in, and talked to him. So it had a really good ending. So that's the important piece. Not so much that, you know, the rudeness is going to happen. You're going to run into it. And the thing is to remain as peaceful, calm as possible because the law is on your side. Now, Paul is a very sensitive person. And so when this discussion was going on, he wasn't expecting it. And, you know, it just really frazzled him. And you could be one of those people who gets frazzled. And sometimes you might need to role play with another person to practice a situation in which someone stops you at a store or a restaurant or in a market and, you know, just role play a little bit so that your mind and your spirit, you know, kind of gets used to the situation and you can fabricate for yourself, you know, certain answers that will help guide the conversation. But again, you know, we all have to be aware. It's very unfortunate that service dogs have been rejected and stopped and not allowed into certain places. Now, why is this happening? I don't know. This could be, you know, a lack of not knowing the ADA. This could be because the owners might be from another country and they don't know. Some people, you know, just might not like dogs, or they're allergic to dogs, so they'll put up all kinds of excuses. But the truth is, they're still allowed in. And for people that have allergies and stuff, that's not an excuse either. So we still, in the community, for those people who use service dogs, we need to continue to educate constantly. And that's where I was saying in one of my videos that you need to be aware of that when you start using a service dog, that this is going to happen and you're going to need to educate over and over, unfortunately. But, you know, I just want to raise up, you know, Paul's situation because it's happened to a lot of people. Over the past maybe 2 years or maybe more. And we need to continue to work in the disability community. For us who use service dogs, I had a service dog. He has since passed away. But his name is Johnny. He was a golden retriever, and he was my hearing dog. So I'm also in a wheelchair, but I wasn't in a wheelchair back then. So Johnny was a great dog, very goofy, had a great sense of humor. But, you know, so in this video, I just want to honor all those service dogs. And I want to raise my cup up to Paul and for a good outcome to his situation and for him to give a big hug to his service dog. And I'm hoping that he has many more positive encounters and positive support out there, as I wish it for everyone else who uses a service dog. And if you look at my other videos, there's other tips in there that you might have not considered. But I raise my cup to all of you and for you to continue to have good and positive experiences, and a cup up to you, Paul, for a positive ending that you had at the restaurant. And, you know, just as a reminder, there are certain places service dogs can't go. That would be in a surgery room. They can go and see a patient, but they can't go into the surgery room per se. They can't go to a zoo. For obvious reasons, there are predators there, and it might, you know, cause some problems, some issues in the zoo. It can't go to safaris because there are predators. You don't want a predator trying to eat your dog. So there are certain places that it is not safe to take your service dog. And so that's why they can say, no, you can't enter because it's not safe. It's not safe for you or your service dog. So it's usually when there are predators or when there is high need to have an absolute sterile environment and the dog cannot come in. So I just want to put that out there so that as a reminder. But anywhere else the public can go, you can go.